Hi, I am David Brown. This video introduces our work on optimization-based design of variable-stiffness mechanisms. The simplest model of a biologically inspired variable-stiffness actuator has two nonlinear springs and a rotary joint. Extending one of the springs can rotate the joint. Extending both springs makes the joint stiffer. A similar kind of stiffness modulation by muscle co-activation is energetically expensive for humans. There is no fundamental physical reason for energetically expensive stiffness modulation, and it is possible to design actuators that provide large length stiffness modulation with low energy cost. But how do we design these actuators, and how do we design a subcomponent of these actuators that provide stiffness modulation with low energy cost? To address this question, we first define the ideal stiffness modulator. According to our definition, the ideal stiffness modulator is one where the power consumed by the motor during stiffness modulation is the same as the power consumed by the motor when decoupled from the stiffness modulator. This definition implies that for the ideal actuator, the motor doesn't feel the elastic force imposed by the stiffness modulator. Thus, minimization of the elastic force appears to provide the optimization principle that drives the design of a practical low-power stiffness modulator. Based on the definition of the ideal actuator, we present an optimization-based design framework for the design of intrinsically low-power stiffness modulators. There are three ingredients in this formulation. First, we have the parameters model of the actuator. Second, we have the potential energy function that provides a mathematical model of this actuator. And third, we have the optimization where the design parameters are found by minimizing the force exerted by the variable stiffness spring on the motor. This formulation enables us to find the optimal design parameters. This formulation can also be used to find the best design by searching through a library of different designs. Finally, this formulation allows us to cross-compare actuators that have different kinematic structure. An example of such cross-comparison is shown here, where on the left side we can see the variable length leaf spring stiffness modulator, which enables large stiffness range with small motor force, compared to the antagonistic actuator, where the stiffness range depends on the size of the actuator and which requires large force for stiffness modulation even when it is operated at its equilibrium configuration. Experimental implementation of the variable length leaf spring stiffness modulator confirms that it enables low and high stiffness operation with low power cost. The 2 watts is only twice the baseline power required by the motor when it is decoupled from this actuator. In summary, the paper presents a novel optimization-based framework for the design of intrinsic low-power variable stiffness systems. The framework can be used to find optimal design parameters. The framework can be used to cross-compare different mechanisms. Finally, the formulation helps us in making non-intuitive design decisions for systems that are difficult to design using experience-based or more classical computational approaches.